The mission of the Bean Life Science Museum is to inspire wonder and to develop stewards of the planet. So those are some of the things that we're accomplishing here with Kayak Camp.
We're inspiring wonder, understanding, and reverence for our planet. You're not going to want to protect something if you don't love it, and you're not going to learn to love it if you don't experience that kind of wonder and awe and amazement at how many beautiful things there are in the world.
Just recently, I've completed a Master of Public Administration, and my capstone project was creating Kayak Camp, where we take kids out to explore the Provo River Delta and learn about wetlands ecology. Studies have shown that as kids are involved with hands-on science, that they develop pro-environmental behaviors, so they become stewards. We have four student educators who are running the program. They basically do all the work. They take the kids out on the kayaks, take them on the hikes, and teach them about the wetlands.
We're here at the Provo River Delta, which is a really cool area both for kayaking and also for learning about conservation. This is a two-day camp for 8 to 12-year-olds, and we've been learning about wetlands, learning about the animals that live there, projects that are going on to help protect them, and then we get to get out here on the water and see it all in person.
We take the kids kayaking, and we take them birding. We've taught them a lot about the June sucker, which is a fish that's only native to Utah Lake and the areas around it, so it's been pretty cool to get them all excited about the place that they live in and the wildlife and plants around it.
Provo River Delta was formed to help protect an endangered fish called the June sucker, and it's also been really magical for other species that live here. This year in the Delta habitat, there's been a nesting pair of bald eagles, and that's been something that we've been able to take the kids to see.
I think there's something that's really fascinating about learning outside of a classroom. We are given the opportunity to observe the world around us. Even right now, I can feel the breeze going past me, and I can see dragonflies. There's just something that makes it so much more real when you're outside. And I think if we were just in a classroom showing them pictures of these things, it wouldn't be as real for them.
You experience that kind of wonder, and we're able to look through your binoculars at a bird and say, wow, I've never seen anything like that before. And I think I've seen a lot of that kind of wonder from the kids. A lot of wows, a lot of, oh my gosh, I didn't know we had pelicans here. A lot of surprise and joy.
Sometimes we'll have kids that come in and you can tell they kind of just don't really want to be there. And then we get out on the water and they get so excited. They just burst with this joy and this light.
I think there's also a deeply spiritual connection to the outdoors. Thinking about all the design, the systems, all these things that happen that we don't even notice from day to day. It's amazing to think of God, who's the creator and the designer of all these things.